Thank you. eventually?
I've never seen anything like this. Okay. It's going on for a long time. Normally one would run off.
Yeah, yeah.
And just try and outrun the other one.
Yeah.
But this male, the one without the scar, is kind of crazy. And I think he's going to try and kill or drown that other one.
Okay.
So I'm going to tell you now, because we've seen something really, really epic today. This male that's pinning down the other one with the scar, he actually came and killed a koi yesterday and ate it.
No.
So a little newborn. So that's why he's got a taste for blood right now. He's like, he's seeing red right now. He's, yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's kind of like a psycho. Like, I would, I'm normally really, really calm around grizzly bears, but this guy, I wouldn't trust.
One, did this guy swim for it?
He could. Whether he's faster than the other one is a question. Grizzly bears can run up to 55 kilometers per hour, so.
I have no idea.
They're both going to be really tired after this, too, so exhaustion is another thing if he swims too far. This is extreme fighting.
They might be too tired to do anything after that.
Well, that's scar, please.
She's only 8 years old. She's been trying to get the males to breed with her, but they're not that interested because she's not very immature yet. So she's trying her luck right now.
The one closest to us.
The koi, yeah. Mm-hmm. The koi, yeah. Mm-hmm. You can hear it popping after all that. they don't normally fight for that long. They'll normally just fight a second and one will take off. But I think because that bear, that one, is like really amped up, and then the other one's like wounded and stuff, I think it's a lot more tension.
Skin must be so tough because it didn't. None of them are bleeding.
It's incredible.
Yeah, and that's like I say, it's when you're coming bear viewing, it's so dynamic. And now they've gone in, you'd have like this one male. This is not the same. And if they were telling you on the dock at lunch that they'd seen that, you'd have been even more. You'd have been really disappointed. Yeah. But that was some National Geographic stuff right there. I hope you guys got some awesome shots. Poor old Dimble. I know how she feels.
She's got time.
Yeah. It might not be her year yet. Well, Dimble's on the shore, and then we've got this guy. I think we should just trade. Maybe Dimble.
I can't see any more blood on him.
He doesn't seem any worse for the wear, does he?
It's incredible.
I have to say, auto-tracking makes the focusing a lot easier. A bit how I used to have to do it.
There's every day out here is good, but some days are epic, and that was one of them.
Oh, who's Vic? Who's who now?
This is actually what I think one of our prettiest bears. Thimble's just beautiful. She's kind of, I think, trying to find that male, but unfortunately for her, he's taken off.
Yay.
Yeah, I think he's scenting after Lenore.
He's a bit pooped.
Yeah, they're flying the scar.
Oh, he's up there, is he?
Yeah, that's him up there, the one with the wound.
Yeah. He's gonna maybe go for Dimple.
Yeah.
Is that other bear went in there?
Oh boy, round two.
Might be round two.
Dimple's just gonna go have a bath. Dimple's having a bath.
Yes.
Thank you.
meters, this feels very, very close.
It can happen that they...
They can walk and swim right by. It happens. Obviously not so much in these boats. Generally, especially in these kind of interactions, they're particularly cautious. Like, you wouldn't want to be too close to that. Yeah. But you're saying you don't want to interrupt them.
Yeah.